everyone, welcome back. In my previous video I have showed you the books in the chest and I told you that we are going to make some hat boxes, shabby chic hat boxes, and I make the templates, I make them myself for round boxes. You can use how you call it, a circle pons, but you can also use a coin or a round object and you draw the line, and for the box and the lid you measure the side of the box and the lid and leave a little bit extra because you can cut it off when it's too big. You measure the height of the box and the lid and you can make it in round shapes and oval shapes. Here is a round shape and here is a round shape, but not a high, so you cut this in half and you have a smaller box. And now I will make the oval shape. You also need the same shape as the lid and the box. You need a cardboard, a piece of cardboard, and this is 2 millimeters. And two pieces for the box and two pieces for the lid. So let me start with the lid. I take this piece of cardboard and glue. I have to refill my glue bottle. Make sure the sides are covered with glue. And then glue it on. And on the other side, do the same. And we leave it to dry. And this is the bottom. Put some glue on it. Glue this on. And on the other side. And the bottom is always, or the box bottom is always smaller than the lid, because the lid has to cover the box. Now we have these strips for the box and the lid, and we are rounded up a little bit, so it's easier to glue it on. Start with the lid. It's not dry yet, but I hope it will work. And then we put some glue on the side of this cardboard. And we take the small one, because that is the lid. We are going to glue in the middle. So this is the widest from the lid, so we start here in the middle. And we go around the lid. And you can see that I've made it too wide, but that's okay because we can cut it off. And we put some glue on the ends. And we glue it over the other side. It's a little bit tricky, but it will work. Where are my little... Here it is. You take a little peg to hold it in place, and then you go push the lid. So this is smooth on the top. And we do the same on the other put some glue on it. And you start in the middle. A little bit tricky, but when you do it the first time, it's always difficult, but when you have made a couple of boxes. And that's my pack. We leave it to dry, and when it's dry I'm going to paint it. When you use an acrylic paint that is transparent, you need gesso for the first coat, but if you use chalk paint then you don't need gesso. This is the box, and I have already made a round box and I have painted it already, the inside and the outside. This is a little bit damaged, but that's okay because we are gluing in the room box. So now you can distress it with this on the bottom, with distress ink. I use a vintage photo and on the lid the same. And this one I have used an image, but I wanted to do something different, and I want to make, if I can find my material, why I can't find, I am so sorry, is it falling on the floor? No. Excuse me for my arm. Sometimes you cannot find it. I got it. You can take a piece of lace with a scalloped lace, and it must be smaller than this, because the lid is covering a piece of the box. So when you put lace on the bottom, it must not touch the box, the lid, sorry. So now I am, what will I do? Yes, on the bottom of the box. And I take, I think I will do this with a hot glue gun. You start in the back and you go around, you cut it like that, and then take a little bit of hot glue so it stays in place. Sorry for the noise. Like that. And on the top of the box, on the lid, I mean the lid, I will do another, if I can find it, I'm so sorry. I'm a little bit clumsy today. Find it. Oh, here it is. I'm so sorry. I take this lace, and I think this was from Ivy Ling, gifted to me by Ivy Ling. Hi Ivy. And I don't need all of the lace. I will cut it in half. And I also use the scalloped side of that lace. Let me see if I've cut in enough. Yes. And I start in the back and I take, this time I take my hot glue gun, and there's glue in it. Thank you. You can use tacky glue or a fiber glue that clears up transparent. Here I have to cut a small piece like that. Come on, glue gun. Then we have this. Make sure you put the back of the lid and of the box together. Where's the back? Here's the back, and this is the back. Now we are going to decorate the lid, and I have roses. Flowers. And a piece of lace. And a rose. I have a flower applique. If you hear a noise, that's my neighbor. He is always busy with home improvements, and now he is busy with the bathroom. The bathroom is next to my craft room, so that's the noise that you hear. Like that. Then I take a piece of lace and I fold it like that. And I place it on the box. Make sure you got the back. Where's the back? This is the back. Like that. And here I have roses. Roses on. Excuse me. Everything is falling down. That, and it's already 19 minutes, ladies. I am so sorry, but I have to stop the video. I want to put some pearls on it. If you put some pearls on, make sure that you do the holes from the pearls on the side so you don't see the holes. I will put a bow on it. And it's almost 21 minutes, so I'm so sorry, ladies, but I have to end this video, and I will see you in the next video to continue to finishing this box. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye for now.